how we're going. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Shannon's, Sarah's wonderful older brother. If you're watching this, it's pretty obvious I couldn't make it to Palmy. I am in London. And I must say, summer in London is a whole lot better than being here during winter. Sarah has asked me very nicely to do a video for her, so here I am, basically talking to a camera and putting bits and pieces together to for her 21st. Sarah, I would have loved to be there tonight. It'll be such a wicked time being able to party with you and all your mates, and even some of my mates are there too, so it'll be great seeing everyone again. You probably don't know this, but I did actually try doing a couple of jobs, odd jobs, to collect the money to get an airfare to go over there. Not all of them worked out, and I didn't actually get the money needed.
Some extra money working at London Zoo. They've given me a little pet. I'm trying to train up a gorilla. This is Rafiki. I've been working here with about a week. We're trying to get some trust going here. I'll just try and get her to let me trust.
Hey, baby, it's all right. Come on. It's all right. It's all right.
I can't remember last time I thanked you, keeping my distance unintentionally, to go from comfort to staying close enough. If I could have more time, we would brainstorm, and I love you tender, but we
might not. Excuse me,
call me loyal. I'll say loyal.
I'm going to talk about Sarah's childhood, because most of you know her throughout high school, and you probably heard about what she's got up to in Sydney, because she's quite famous for that. Basically, there was two kids from Cheryl. There was myself and Sarah. Unless there's anybody else, Mum, you want to tell us anything? No? Alright. So if I was actually born a girl first, I would have been called Sarah. And Sarah, being the second girl, would have been called Fleur. Now, she absolutely hates this name. So I think, as a 21st present from me to you, Sarah, I think everyone else should call you Fleur for the rest of the night. Right, we're going to get a bit of interaction going here through from London all the way to Palmerston North. So on the count of three, we're all going to say happy birthday, Fleur. All right, one, two, three, happy birthday, Fleur. Sarah, from a young age, has always been loud, dramatic, and quite lazy. She's always been bossing people around and telling people what they're doing. Do it her way, it's not the right way. I'm pretty sure when she grew up, she thought she should have been royalty. Actually, I'm pretty sure she wanted to be the queen when she grew up. Now, I actually heard this story from one of Sarah's mates in Sydney that couldn't actually make it there tonight. She met up with this guy at a rock festival, and I really liked him, thought he was quite cute. He's got his number and met up with him a couple of times. Eventually one thing led to another, and she ended up staying the night at his house. He actually had to get up early to go to work the next day, and he didn't understand to her, oh, just make sure you lock up when you go out, it's no problem. So she lies in bed, sleeps in for a little bit, and just before she goes out, she realizes, oh, you know, she really needs to go to the toilet. So she does number two, and basically when she goes to flush, it wouldn't work. And she's like, oh no, what do I do? This is a really nice guy, I just can't leave this mess sitting in the toilet. So she goes to the house, finds the plastic bag, grabs everything out, and gets, you know, ties up the bag and everything. She writes a note saying, oh, you know, thanks a lot, thanks for the night, basically, and I'll catch you soon. As soon as the door hits her on the way out, she realizes, I've left the bag right by the note. Needless to say, she didn't actually hear from that guy again. Rafiki. Rafiki, she's been spotted in the area. We've had some claims that she's been causing a bit of trouble, and I'm basically just up in this banana skin to try and lure her to me. Hopefully she'll be able to smell my scent and then recognise me.
Oh, fuck.
G'day, Sarah. How the bloody hell are you? You're still trying to get away from those flaming kiwis, are you? I know there are harder to shake off than a croc in a grotty, in a drawer. Shit, sorry. How many of the sheep shaggers are with you now? Have a good one from the token Aussies, Bruno.
So, Sarah, you're 21. That's great news for me because I'm not going to feel like a sicko when I hit on your mates. Jared and Nick never cared about the age gap, but I have morals. Have a great birthday. Peace out.
Old Prodog, I can never keep up with her at raves. She parties like a 60-year-old. Those were the days. Happy 21st.
For Rick and Kate, happy birthday, Trash Bag. We think we're all thinking of you tonight. We love you and miss you lots. Our house hasn't been quite as clean since you left. In fact, we've missed quite a few things about you. Always the ones who remember the camera to capture us in our most drunk and twisted states.
The way you would make us look hot in photos because you would always pull the most retarded faces next to us.
Having to keep up with you because you power walk everywhere.
The way you keep us constantly informed of upcoming events, sometimes even months in advance. Finding you asleep on our couch the next morning, still with your sunglasses on.
Messing with your head by opening all the kitchen cupboard doors before you come over, just so we could watch you close them and tell us off. Laughing at poos and wheeze with you.
The way you would entertain us while at public events, when you would find bright, pointy, cone-shaped objects to sit on.
We hope you have an amazing night. You mean a lot to us, Sarah, and we can't wait to be reunited with your booze hag self again. Keep it up.
Happy 21st, Sarah. You're going to dominate with your acting and writing talents. Nobody can match Crow Dog's 40-year-old virginity and scattered memoirs. Love you lots.
Hi, Sarah, it's Meg.
Dear Sarah, I miss your smile, your soft skin and gentle touch, oh the touch. Your locks of blonde sweetness and your super huge mirrored wardrobe. On a slightly more serious and less sexually confused note, I miss you heaps, chick, and hope you're tearing up the streets of Palmy with your weird bending toes and your Sydney tinted savvy and you're only trying to get into houses that you actually have the key for. I'm yet to find another Chicana like yourself to come and sit with me at the smelly fish markets and yip about the meaning of life and why boys dance the way they do while drinking water out of massive steins. Oh, so satisfying. Well, I'm sure there are many speeches to get through, so take care, my little blonde muppet, and send me pics of all those shoes you buy and promise to visit sometime soon.
At one time when Sarah's about 7 or 8, Mum and I heard his crying, so I both end up running.